wasting no time, having suddenly become aware of what had happened, I phoned over to the boys and told them. But they did not believe me, so I became extremely angry and swore at him. I told him I would phone the commanding officer myself, who was at home 8 miles away with his family when this evil thing hit us, also warning him to listen to Daphne screaming, which should tell him something. You see, all the 3 years we had been in Sutton Valence, nothing had ever actually happened to any of us in our huts, and when it did, no one could believe. I did call the CO and the ambulance and told those idiot RAF men to get over with 2 stretchers for Helen and Daphne, as they had to be taken down to the entrance gate, which was a good 300 yards walk. Unfortunately, nothing can be bandaged when needles of glass are sticking up from someone's head. And Daphne just wouldn't stop screaming while poor Helen was quiet as a mouse. And I was doing my best for all 3 of us. The CO arrived at the gate about 30 minutes later, and the very first words he spoke to me, "Well, lass, is there any damage to the wireless sets?" I could have nailed him. Not once did he ask how any of us were. Later, he received the oak leaf for bravery during this incident. He had been at home in bed with his wife at that time, and we were furious.